Hi everyone, thanks for stopping by my channel. Today's going to be a super casual video again. It's part of my minimalism journey and it's going to be a declutter and tips on how to maximize your closet space video. It's because I have been neglecting cleaning out and also organizing my drawers ever since I started hanging up my backgrounds for my Instagram pictures, which by the way, if you don't follow me, my social handles are always up here. I can't obviously go in and out of my drawers that easily because the background's pretty much like just covered up this entire space. Like I'll show you here. Like I have my clothes line up here. I literally just like hang my background up. So we're going to go look into my drawers. I'm most likely going to try some of the things on to see if I need to get rid of them. Let's do the tour first. Here is my sock drawer. This isn't like socks that you wear with shoes. This is my sleep sock drawer. So yes, it is completely filled with my socks. Obviously on top you want to put the things that you wear all the time, and there are a lot of socks I just don't wear anymore. I just don't want to get rid of them though. These are the two that I grabbed for the most because they're very, very warm. And the rest, I basically just stuffed each sock into each other, and that's how I just keep track of them. And a lot of them get stuck like back in the drawer, so it's really nice to put your socks like this. So that's just what I do for this drawer. And I fixed this like 2 weeks ago or something, so don't have to fix that. My actual sock drawer is in my parents' room, which I can show you that, sure. These are my other drawers. I wear these in the winter because they're really thick socks. I actually didn't even bother organizing this, so I don't know, maybe another day. And then I have another sock drawer. These are my ankle socks that I wear with my ankle booties or with sneakers. Actually, with sneakers, I wear Vans and they're really low cut, so I wear these flat socks. That way the sock doesn't show, which I hate. And then in this drawer are my sleep socks. So these are my other sleep socks. These are my thigh highs and my knee highs, which I don't really wear that much anymore. This one has all my camisoles that I wear underneath my blouses that I used to buy, which by the way, I have a video on the things that I don't buy anymore. I will link them in the description box. But yeah, I still have them just in case. I do have some blouses, some shirts that do need to have camisoles underneath. I also have these undergarment things for skirts. In this drawer, I have some PJ tops. Oh, I guess I just have this one in here. I can take this over. And then my swimsuits. This drawer is a little bit of a mess. This is basically footwear things like soles. I have my ski mask in here. Here when I went skiing a long time ago with my family. I got another pair of gloves. This actually should go in my parents' room. I have earmuffs. I just have like a bunch of things in here I just do not use anymore. I have so many of my old belts that I used to wear in high school. So I think I'm going to go through this drawer with you guys later and get rid of a lot of things that are in there. In this drawer, I have all my bras. I do have them color coordinated. I basically just put them like this because you don't want to fold them because then you'll ruin the cup. I have my black ones in the front, white like neutral ones here. I have my nude ones here. If some of them are like sitting more on top, it's just because like I'm running out of space here. But also I do grab for these bras all the time. And then in the back I have like colored ones that I don't really wear all the time. This is my underwear drawer. These are my period panties. These are like my workout boy shorts. Well, I work out naked now, so I don't really wear these for workouts anymore. And I have these that are not like thong cheekies, so I don't like to wear these out in public because you can see the panty lines, but I just like to have these. I have my sleep silk hat thing, beanie thing. I have my sleep masks here, and I have extra bra straps in here. And this is my favorite sticky bra. In this drawer, this is definitely a mess, are half long sleeve shirts in the back, and the rest are PJs. And I know you'll see in a second that I have a lot of pajamas. I'm obsessed. And here I have my main underwears. I have my thongs. I have my cheekies. Yeah, I'm gonna have to fix this, but you can kind of see a little bit of like the color groups that I had them in originally. In the back here, PJs. And then in the back here, I have bralettes. If you're wondering why I have these plastic things over the top, it's just to protect the clothes, you know, moths, dust, etc. This is my summer PJ drawer. Here was my winter PJ drawer. And then here is the rest of my winter PJ drawer, so moving on to this one over here. These are all of my tank tops. Again, everything's like color coordinated, but it all got messed up. Then in this drawer, I have some of my boyfriend's shirts in here because he couldn't bring a lot with him back, or a lot back with him. There we go. I have my t-shirt collection here. That's basically it. It's just the stuff in the back. And then more summer PJs. And then in this drawer are shorts and some skirts. And then in here are my workout clothes. This drawer is like never touched, which is why it looks a lot more organized than my other drawers, and also because I stopped buying workout clothes, so I don't ever add to it anymore. And then on this side are swimsuit cover-ups. And then in this drawer are my big t-shirts for sleep. And then over here, I have some pullover hoodies from high school, college. So here are all of my old belts and whatnot. I do not wear belts anymore. This was one of my favorites. I used to wear this all the time in high school. Look how freaking brand new this thing looks too. Just going to stack them like this, kind of like snakes run onto each other. My cousin got this for me for my birthday. It says Leeann on it. One got lost back here. There we go. Okay, to prevent having a really long video, I'm going to show you how I do this one drawer, and then basically I'll just speed run through all the other ones. To maximize my drawer space, since I have a lot of stuff, what I do with the pants is I have the pants like this, and then I like to fold it in half lengthwise, and then I will fold it this way and then this way again. And I think this time, because I was actually stacking them on top of each other like this, what I'm going to do is what I did with my shirts in the other drawers, is I'm going to fold it an extra time, and that way that when I put it into my drawer, you can see them. So basically, like when you open up your drawer, you can see them all stacked here, not on top of each other. So I will go through the rest of the shirts and show you what I'm talking about. So for instance, with one of these tops, I will fold it like this, and then fold it kind of like you were working in retail, and then fold it again. And then I'll have this part sitting up like this, and then just put it in like this so that I can see my shirts. All right, I finished with this drawer. It looks so much better than before because now you can see all the stuff. So I will close it and then I'll open it and I'll see all of my sets. And it's okay if you stack clothes on top of other clothes, because as long as you put them in the same style and not just like, you know, lay them flat out, it's totally fine. Like, you know that there are PJ sets underneath that. These are my freaking summer PJs. Right now I'm just putting them in however I want to. You can do like shorts over here and then tops over here if they're not matching. But for me, it doesn't really matter. I don't have a lot of matching sets. You know what, guys? This video is actually getting really long because it does take me a really long time to get through each drawer. So what I'm gonna do is I will come back at the end of the video and I'll just show you guys the end results of everything. And I'll even show you my donation pile because it's pretty big. Before I show you the results of my drawers, I actually wanted to show you how I fold my underwear to maximize my space in here. And this is a folding technique that I learned years ago, and it basically changed my life because I clearly have a lot of underwears, and oh yeah, surprise surprise, I changed it into a tank top because I was sweating like crazy. But anyways, for instance, I'll take one of my boy shorts. You just fold it like the sides on top of each other like this, and then you take the crotch part and then put it into the very first layer in the front of the underwear so that you create a pocket. And there we go. So here we have a bikini. Put it on its face. Fold this side, then this side on top of the other one. Take the crotch part and then put it into the first layer here. And there we have a little pocket bikini. All right, guys, after like an hour of reorganizing most of my drawers, here is the big reveal. Here's a black box that my mom bought two of to help me store some of my things. And here is where my boyfriend actually stored a lot of his clothes. So I'm going to show you how I fold the clothes.
Put the thing on top. Oh my god. I think the clothes stretched it out so much that the cover won't even go on it. It's not completely, you know, there's a little bit of a bounce here, but yay, y'all.
Everything looks so much better now. I can open and close the drawers without any problems. Now I'm going to show you my donation pile. And I'm really excited to give these things away because not only were they just sitting in my drawers for years, but I like to donate things at the end of the year because I always think about the people that really need clothes for the winter. I'm excited to give all of this away, and including my bag full of belts. I don't have a lot of room in my closet, so that's why I did not go in there. And I already fixed it up like so many times within the past year. So I will include that in my room tour, which will be coming up in December actually, because I already have some videos that are lined up for this week. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to see more videos from me. Click the notification bell so you know when my videos go live. Follow me on my platforms. I always have them linked below and up on the corner, probably right here. And I will see you all in my next video. Have a wonderful day. Bye.